Halle Laura Channel, you're watching Steelers flag down Bengals at gun. Ugly. Nasty. Physical. And the Bengals were on the short end of it when they committed a frat. Chai's record 168 yards in penalties and blowing a 17-point lead in a 23-20 loss Monday night at rainy Paul Brown Stadium. It was classic Bengals Steelers and it could have been 1975 or 2017. Ugly. Nasty. Physical. And the Bengals were on the short end of it when they committed a franchise record 168 yards in penalties and blowing a 17-point lead in a 23-20 loss Monday night at rainy Paul Brown Stadium. Kicker Chris Boswell won it with a 38-yard field goal at the gun fittingly after he moved 5 yards closer on a penalty on Josh Shaw for jumping offsides. The marquee defensive players from each team left on a backboard when Steelers linebacker Ryan Shazier collided with rookie wide receiver Josh Malone early in the first quarter and Bengals linebacker Vontaze Burfict exited with 6 minutes left when rookie wide receiver Juju Smith-Schuster gave him a cheap shot on a blindside block and then stepped over him, straddled him, and picked up a taunting penalty as well as a roughing penalty. Burfict waved his arm to the crowd to signal he was okay. But the Bengals were not. With Burfict gone, the Bengals were down to 3 linebackers with middleman Kevin Minter not a good match for Steelers quarterback Ben Roethlisberger's hottest offensive in the NFL. After Burfict left, Big Ben just shot-putted the ball into the middle of the field, first to running back Le'Veon Bell, then to Schuster, then to tight end Jesse James, then to wide receiver Antonio Brown for the tying touchdown with 3:57 left. When safety George Iloka was called for hitting Brown in the head, the Bengals were backed up on the kickoff. Then they couldn't convert a 3rd and 2 when the Steelers rushed 3 and forced quarterback Andy Dalton to take a coverage sack. When the Steelers caught the punt at their 42, Roethlisberger made quick work to set up Boswell's winner. Early in the 4th quarter the Bengals couldn't get off the field on 3rd and 10 when Bell got about 9 and 3 quarters on one of those pesky screens and it forced Steelers head coach Mike Tomlin to go for it on 4th and inches from his side of the field. Bell smashed for it for ease with 7 yards. Then the Steelers got a gift when cornerback Dre Kirkpatrick was called for his 2nd pass interference penalty of the night when he seemed to simply defend wide receiver Martavis Bryant on a deep ball. That was a 30-yarder and gave the Bengals 133 yards in penalties. They held, but Chris Boswell's 37-yard field goal cut it 20-13 with 10:04 left in the game. Then the Bengals' offensive line imploded and let linebacker Vince Williams walk in for a 12-yard sack to blow up that drive. It was a wild 3rd quarter that saw both teams get touchdowns called back by penalty. It looked like the Bengals had gone up by 24-10 on Dalton's 61-yard TD bomb to Green that Green turned into a wondrous play when he ran away from 2 tacklers at the Steelers' 20. But running back Giovanni Bernard was called for holding outside linebacker TJ Watt rushing Dalton up the middle. Dalton and wide receiver Brandon LaFell saved the drive when Dalton hit him streaking down the right sideline for another 3rd down conversion, this one for 27 yards on 3rd and 16. That made the Bengals 7-for-10 on 3rd down conversions after they hit just 3 of 11 in Pittsburgh back in October. Randy Bullock got back 3 of the 7 points when he hit a 41-yard field goal that made the Bengals lead 20-10 with left in the 3rd quarter. And they literally gave the Steelers their first touchdown of the night earlier in the 3rd quarter when running back Le'Veon Bell took a check down pass, high-stepped down the left sideline and on one of the wackiest plays you'll ever see. Linebacker Jordan Evans and cornerback William Jackson both held up and let him walk in the rest of the way for a 25-yard touchdown. As the rain began to fall in the dying but dizzying seconds of the first half, the Bengals couldn't quite flip the script after taking a 17-0 lead with 31 seconds left on Dalton's 2nd 3rd down touchdown pass of the night to wide receiver A.J. Green. But suddenly the karma switched off when safety George Iloka missed an interception tipping off shoulder pad. Roethlisberger then hit Bell for Pittsburgh's longest play of the half on a 33-yard check down pass aided by at least one missed tackle. Then Big Ben just stepped back and flung it deep for wide receiver Antonio Brown and the NFL's leading receiver drew a 37-yard pass interference penalty when cornerback Dre Kirkpatrick tackled him to prevent a touchdown. That, unbelievably, allowed Chris Boswell to kick a 30-yarder at the gun to cut Cincinnati's lead to 17-3, marking the 19th time in the last 23 game the Steelers have scored in the last 2 minutes of the half against the Bengals. It's also the sixth time in the last 7 games Cincinnati has allowed a field goal in the last 2 minutes of the half. It marred a great by the Bengals in stoning the NFL's hottest offense on 126 yards in the half and holding the torrid Big Ben to 50% completions of 8 of 16 for just 109 yards. That's because they had only 24 plays as the Bengals built up a nearly 8-minute edge in time of possession. Dalton hit 16 of 23 for 173 yards and a 120.4 passer rating while they rang up 80 yards rushing on May 7th per on the way to converting 6 of 8 third downs. It was a typical Bengals-Steelers slugfest. After Steelers linebacker Ryan Shazier left the field taped to a board after a frightening collision, the Bengals lost cornerbacks Adam Jones, groin, and Darcus Dennard, knee, and running back Joe Mixon, head/shoulder, during the course of the first half. Jones and Mixon, concussion, was lost for the night and Dennard came back in the second half. It was a tough break for Mixon, who collided with linebacker Vince Williams after picking up 8 yards on a screen and left with 34 yards on 7 carries. Giovanni Bernard picked up 35 on 6 carries once Mixon exited. Green, who had 7 catches for 77 yards in the half, kept that last touchdown drive going when Dalton scrambled out of the pocket on 3rd and 16 and hit Green on a 17-yard comeback route against beleaguered cornerback Cody Sensabaugh. On 3rd and 11 from the Pittsburgh 15, the Steelers blitzed 2 corners and with Bernard and right tackle Andre Smith picking it up, Green destroyed Sensabaugh over the middle for a 15-yard touchdown catch. That capped a 15-play drive that consumed 6:13 before it all went to hell. That was the 52nd career scoring strike for Green and Dalton, passing Kenny Anderson and Isaac Curtis to become the Bengals' all-time leaders. The Bengals ran it 6 times and passed it 6 times on another grinding 85-yard touchdown drive that took 6:34 off the clock and gave them a 10-0 lead with 41 seconds left in the first quarter. It began with a play-action pass over the middle to wide-open tight end C.J. Uzomah for 21 yards. His 4th catch and longest play of the year. It ended when Green buckled Sensabaugh in one-on-one coverage for a 9-yard touchdown pass on 3rd down. Green faked inside, Sensabaugh fell down, and Green floated to the outside wide open. In between Mixon got good tread in the running game, busting a 10-yarder running behind fullback Ryan Hewitt out of the eye and then taking a handoff out of the shotgun formation and running past a blitz for 9 more. Dalton also gunned a quick 3rd-and-2 completion to wide receiver Brandon LaFell to keep the drive going early. The Bengals looked like they were going to tack on to the lead after left end Carlos Dunlap twisted with tackle Geno Atkins and sacked Roethlisberger on 3rd down. Then Dalton went play action out of a heavy formation and hit Green down the middle for 16 yards and Mixon sheared off a draw for a big run. But center Russell Bodine was called for holding to blow up the drive. Dennard blitzed off the slot on the Steelers' first 3rd down, a 3rd-and-6, and Roethlisberger hurried it across the middle into the arms of Adam Jones for his first interception of the year and then how about this for a script change? Bell mauled Bengals linebacker Vontaze Burfict in the helmet as he fell on top of him. Burfict ignored him and ran off the field delighted that Bell was hit for a 15-yard roughing penalty that put Cincinnati on the Steelers' 44. It was a costly play. Jones suffered a groin injury, was done and William Jackson replaced him. That put the Bengals down to the nub with just 3 corners with Kavari Russell inactive. After a 19-yard pass to tight end Tyler Croft down the seam on their first snap of the game, the Bengals stalled. When Shazier collided with Bengals rookie wide receiver Josh Malone on a short pass over the middle, he crumpled to the ground and while he showed movement in his upper body, his lower body appeared motionless. His helmet was taped on a board and carted off the field past stunned players on both teams. There was no immediate update on his condition. On 3rd-and-2 from the Steelers 17, Dalton tried to hit Green on a go route running past cornerback Artie Burns and Green had a step on him, but the ball was overthrown. Randy Bullock then converted a 35-yard field goal for a 3-0 lead with 4 minutes gone in the game. Thank you, Please share video and subscribe my channel for more video.